Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to transform a photo of a structure into the look of an architect's blueprint drawing. This is an update of tutorials I've done on earlier versions of Photoshop. The methods in this tutorial are more efficient and customizable. For your convenience, I provided this paper texture so you can follow along. Its link is located in this video's description or project files. Open a photo that you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from dreamstime.com. To ensure that your results will look similar to mine, let's check your photo's resolution. Go to Image and Image Size. If the resolution isn't 150 pixels per inch, just type it in. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. To fit it back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. We'll convert our photo into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Smart objects also allow us to replace a photo with another without having to redo all the effects. Go to Filter, Stylize, and find Edges. Next, we'll create a border surrounding our image. Click the FX icon and click Stroke. If the color box isn't white, just click on it, and when the color picker opens, pick White. I'll make the size 20 pixels, but you may want to adjust this amount depending on the size of your image. Make the position inside. Click Inner Glow. Make the color black, the source edge, and the choke 100%. I'll make the size 21 pixels, which is 1 pixel more than my stroke. Then I'll click OK. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Black White. This removes all the color from your image. Open the paper texture that I provided and with your Move tool, drag it onto the tab of your blueprint. Without releasing your mouse or pen, press and hold Shift as you drag it down onto your image and release. Holding Shift kept the paper texture centered over your document. To resize the texture, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. If you can't see the transform's entire bounding box, press Ctrl or Command 0 to see it all. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out until the texture is sized to your photo. Then press Enter or Return twice to accept it. Change its blend mode to Linear Burn. We'll brighten the image by clicking the adjustment layer icon and clicking Levels. Make the input highlights level 200. Next, we'll give our image a blue tint. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Click the foreground color, and when the color picker opens, type into the hexadecimal field 0036A5. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Your foreground color is now the blue color we just picked. To fill the empty layer with the foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Change its blend mode to Screen. Next, we'll create a box to place our text into. For this image, I'll place it at the upper left corner, although feel free to place it at any corner you like for your image. Click the thumbnail of your image to make it active, and then double-click it to open the original photo. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Open the Rectangular Marquee tool and drag it over the section you'd like your text to go into. You can always change it later if you want. We'll fill it with white, and since white is the background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Then, deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Make a composite snapshot of your visible image by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Click the X on the tab to close the image, and when you see this message, click Yes to save the changes to your smart object. Immediately, the smart object updated itself with the new shape. Make the black-white adjustment layer active. Our text will be placed above it. Open your horizontal type tool and pick a handwritten architectural-like font. I'm using Draftsman Regular. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. I'll make it size 12 points, sharp, and left alignment. Its color is black. Click on the box and type out your text. To increase the space between all of your characters, highlight your text and press and hold Alt or Option plus the right arrow key on your keyboard. To reposition it, open your Move tool and move it. To place another line of text under it, press T to open your Type tool and click below your text. If you want to decrease its point size, just type in a lower amount. I'll type in 8 points and type out my line of text. I'll open my Move tool to move it. Generally, in architectural perspective drawings, as in this example, it's a 2-point perspective with all the verticals parallel on the page. There's a simple way to accomplish this effect with the upright mode under lens correction in Photoshop CC. If you're working on version CC, you can follow along. But first, let's group the text into a folder to save a little space in the Layers panel. Shift-click the bottom text layer to make both text layers active, and press Ctrl or Command G. Let's name it Text. Click the thumbnail of your drawing to make it active, and go to Filter and Camera Raw Filter. Click the Lens Correction icon to open that filter. If you're using version CC 2015.5 as I am, you'll see this message telling us that the upright moved to the Transform tool. Click on the message, which opens another message asking us if we want to go to the Transform tool so we can use the upright filter. Click Yes. Click the box with the vertical lines. This automatically applies vertical perspective corrections. Then click OK. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.